simplified. So today we are going to talk about a topic from general surgery, that is trauma. So basically we are going to talk about trauma. So whenever we are talking about trauma ke bare mein sabse pehli cheez, it is the most common cause of death in age group, that is 1 to 44 or 45, right? Now there are few cause of death in trauma which you should know, few immediate causes, few causes in which the cause of death is the death of the patient occurs after few hours or in 1 hour, right? So what are the COD of trauma? COD is not cash on delivery, it is cause of death, right? So the immediate cause, death occurring immediately after trauma, it is due to two things. One, either it is a severe head injury, right? Or in case of a transection of great vessels. Alright, so in case of a transection of a great vessel like carotid vessel, jugular vein, etc. So there can be a immediately death of a patient after trauma or in case of any severe head injury. Next, we are talking about the death of a patient after trauma. Within an hour. मतलब एक घंटे के अंदर ट्रॉमा हुआ, उसके एक घंटे के अंदर पेशेंट की डेथ हो रही है. व्हाट आर दोज कॉजेस? एंड दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू नो. सो द फर्स्ट इज अक्यूट एयरवे ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन. सडनली किसी भी रीजन से एयरवे ऑब्स्ट्रक्ट हो गया तो पेशेंट की डेथ हो सकती है. सेकेंड, अक्यूट ट्रेकियोब्रोंकियल इंजरी. सो आई विल जस्ट राइट ट्रेकियोब्रोंकियल इंजरी. Tracheobronchial injury. After this, in list is the pneumothorax, and the pneumothorax can be either open or tension pneumothorax. Open or tension pneumothorax. Dono hi case mein the cause of death, the death of a patient can occur within an hour after the trauma. Fourth is hemothorax. Hemothorax. चेस्ट के अंदर थोरैक्स के अंदर खून जम जाना, बेसिकली इन द लंग्स, इज कॉल्ड एज हीमोथोरैक्स. इस केस में भी पेशेंट का डेथ हो सकता है एक घंटे के अंदर अगर उसे मेडिकल फैसिलिटीज अवेलेबल नहीं कराएगी. फिफ्थ इज अक्यूट सर्कुलेशन अरेस्ट. किसी भी रीजन से सर्कुलेशन अगर स्टॉप हो रहा है तो भी पेशेंट की डेथ हो सकती है विद इन एन आवर. एंड लास्ट वी हैव कार्डियक टेम्पोनेट. कार्डियक सी टेम्पोनेट. नाउ this conditions, all the six in which the death of a patient is occurring within an hour, is called as life threatening injuries. Okay, so I want you guys to remember this six name at least, the in which the cause of death or the death of the patient occurs within an hour after trauma. First is the acute airway obstruction, second is the tracheobronchial injury, third is pneumothorax, anyone, open or tension pneumothorax, fourth is hemothorax, fifth acute circulatory arrest, and sixth is cardiac tamponade. In all this condition, the death of the patient will occur within an hour after a trauma, and this conditions are mentioned as life-threatening injuries. Next, C is death after a week, after a few days or week, right? What are those conditions in which the death of the patient can occur after few days or within a week? First is delayed head injury. And second is sepsis. In dono condition mein patient ki death ho sakti hai after few days of trauma. Right, so this was the basic cause of death regarding the trauma. In the trauma, the main focus is on the ATLS guideline, which we'll be talking very soon. But before that, these are few things from where the questions might be asked. So I am mentioning you right now. Next, we'll talk about the golden hour of trauma. one thing which is called as golden hour in trauma. What is golden hour in trauma? मतलब एक time stipulated है, hour stipulated है, इतने time में अगर medical facility available होगी तो we can save the patient, we can save the life of the traumatized patient, right? So what is golden hour in trauma? It is the first hour after the trauma. It is the first hour after the trauma. Similarly, there is a platinum minute. Platinum minute का मतलब ये हो गया कि उस मिनट, इतने मिनट में एटलीस्ट कोई देख ले कि पेशेंट को ट्रॉमा हुआ है. प्लैटिनम मिनट्स एंड ट्रॉमा, सो देन ही कैन रन टू आस्क फॉर हेल्प, राइट? सो द प्लैटिनम मिनट इन ट्रॉमा इज फर्स्ट 10 मिनट्स आफ्टर ट्रॉमा, राइट? सो दिस वाज बेसिक कॉज ऑफ डेथ एंड बेसिक फ्यू बेसिक थिंग विच यू शुड नो इन द ट्रॉमा चैप्टर फ्रॉम जनरल सर्जरी. नाउ वील गो फर्दर एंड वील टॉक अबाउट अ सिस्टम विच इज डन इन द केस ऑफ मास कैजुअलिटी. जब भी बहुत ज्यादा कैजुअलिटी होती है, जब भी ज्यादा पेशेंट इंजर्ड होते हैं एज कम्पेयर टू द मेडिकल फैसिलिटी और हॉस्पिटल केयर अवेलेबल, देन दैट कंडीशन इज नोन एज मास कैजुअलिटी. इन दैट वी क्लासीफाई द पेशेंट्स, वी क्लासीफाई द इंजर्ड पीपल अकॉर्डिंग टू द सिवियरिटी और सेल्वेजिबिलिटी, मतलब कि उनको बचाया जा सकता है कि नहीं या कितने टाइम में बचाया जा सकता है, उस तरह से हम उनको डिवाइड करते हैं. वी बाइफोकेट देम एंड वी गिव अ कलर कोडिंग सिस्टम, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज ट्रायज. सो नेक्स्ट वी विल टॉक अबाउट द ट्रायज. नेक्स्ट वी विल टॉक अबाउट द ट्रायज. नाउ ट्रायज इज डन टू सॉर्ट द पेशेंट्स. सेकेंड, ट्रायज इज डन टू सॉर्ट पेशेंट्स in a mass casualty event. Mass casualty event. Now what is this mass casualty? I told you that any condition in which number of people injured is very much higher as compared to the medical facility or healthcare available. So healthcare available, ठीक है? तो ऐसे मास कैजुअलिटी इवेंट में वी डू ट्रायज. नाउ ट्रायज इज बेसिकली बेस्ड ऑन अ कलर कोडिंग सिस्टम. द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ ट्रायज, वंस इट वाज आस्क्ड इन नीट, प्रिंसिपल ऑफ ट्रायज इज टू सेव एज मेनी लाइफ पॉसिबल in little time. Okay, now we'll talk about the color coding system. Color coding system is divided into red, then there is a yellow color, after that we have green, and at the end we have black. Okay, so the triage is divided into red, yellow, green, black. Red are those patients who need urgent intervention or else they will die. Yellow are those who can be stabilized and the definitive management can wait. Green are those in which there is a minor bruise, right? We call them as a walking wound patient. Matlab, ilaj na bhi karo to ek bar ke liye wo bache rahenge. That is in green category. And black are those patients who are already died or just about to die. That is moribund patient, right? So first we'll write about the red category. Red category are those who need urgent intervention. Okay, for example, all those life-threatening injury which I mentioned, जिसमें death हो रही थी एक घंटे के अंदर after trauma, all those six life-threatening injuries like airway obstruction, tracheobronchial injury, pneumothorax, hemothorax, circulatory arrest or cardiac tamponade, in उन सारी conditions में they are categorized into red category because they need urgent intervention. So all life threatening injuries. Next we'll talk about yellow category. Yellow category ka maine kya bola aapko, those patient who need stabilization but they can wait for definitive management, definitive management. अब सपोज कोई फ्रैक्चर का पेशेंट है, तो उसको पेन हो रहा है, तो वी व्हाट विल डू, वी विल जस्ट स्टेबलाइज हिम, वी विल जस्ट ट्राई टू डिक्रीज हिज पेन एंड टेल हिम टू वेट फॉर अ व्हाइल टिल दैट वी विल हेल्प द रेड कैटेगरी पेशेंट, राइट? सो नीड स्टेबिलाईजेशन बट कैन वेट फॉर डेफिनेटिव मैनेजमेंट, जो उसका प्लास्टर हमें करना है दैट कैन वेट, राइट? सो दैट इज अबाउट द येलो कैटेगरी. एन एग्जाम्पल इज, एग्जाम्पल हियर इज फ्रैक्चर्स, राइट? नेक्स्ट इज अबाउट ग्रीन कैटेगरी. नेक्स्ट इज अबाउट ग्रीन कैटेगरी. ग्रीन कैटेगरी आई राइट हियर, आई टोल्ड यू ग्रीन आर पेशेंट हु आर कॉलिंग वॉकिंग वुंड पेशेंट, वॉकिंग वुंड पेशेंट, वॉकिंग वुंड पेशेंट. एग्जाम्पल क्या है इनमें, लैसरेशन, ब्रूज एक्सेट्रा, राइट? एंड एट द एंड वी हैव द ब्लैक कैटेगरी, दैट इज द डेड और मोरीबंड पेशेंट, डेड और मोरीबंड पेशेंट हु आर अबाउट टू डाई वेरी सून और ऑलरेडी डाइड. सो दिस ट्रायल सिस्टम आर बेस्ड ऑन थ्री इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग, फर्स्ट द सैलवेजेबिलिटी, सेकेंड द अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ द रिसोर्सेज टू ट्रीट द पेशेंट्स, एंड द सिवियरिटी ऑफ इंजरी, राइट? सो जस्ट राइट दिस थ्री थिंग. द ट्रायल इज बेस्ड ऑन फर्स्ट द सिवियरिटी ऑफ इंजरी, सेकेंड, फर्स्ट इज सिवियरिटी ऑफ इंजरी, सेकेंड इज सैलवेजिबिलिटी. वॉट इज सैलवेजिबिलिटी, द एबिलिटी टू सर्वाइव, मतलब इनमें से कौन सा पेशेंट सर्वाइव कर सकता है वो भी हम कैटेगराइज कर रहे हैं. सो सैलवेजिबिलिटी, एंड द थर्ड इज अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ रिसोर्सेस, अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ रिसोर्सेस. सपोज देर इज अ केस ऑफ hemothorax, there is a person having hemothorax and you need to put ICD immediately, but you don't have any ICD in your department or in your hospital, or if you have ICD you don't have a surgeon who is capable to put an ICD, example. So in that case how will you manage it? We cannot, right? So that is the thing, the triage is based on severity of injury, salvageability and availability of the resource. Now we will talk about the main thing in the trauma, that is the ATLS guideline. Right, so the ATLS full form is Advanced Trauma Life Support. The full form is Advanced Trauma Life Support. In this, we use a principle that is called as ABCD. Very simple, ABCD padho or ATLS guideline padho. So principle is based on ABCD. Now what is this ABCD? These are the part of the primary survey, right? So what is this ABCD? A is for airway, B is for breathing, C is for circulation and D is for disability management. So I'll write down one by one. A is for airway management, MX is management, B is for breathing management, C is for circulation and D is for disability management. Disability management. Right. So in all the cases, we follow ABCD. But suppose there is a war field. In war field, what happens? There comes a small C before this ABCD. There comes a small C before this ABCD. This small C is control of exsanguinating, control of exsanguinating bleeding or hemorrhage. Excessive bleeding hota hai war field mein. So sabse pehle war field mein we try to manage that and then we will look out over the airway, breathing and circulation. Theek hai? So now first we'll talk about this airway. Theek hai? Airway mein kya kya problem ho sakti hai, usko hum kaise manage karte hai. Then we'll talk about breathing, then circulation and disability. Disability management, basically we focus on the neurological status of the patient. In that we have a GCS score, that is Glasgow Coma score, and we'll talk about it also. Now we'll talk about the first, airway management. Airway management. Now in airway management, you should remember, first thing to be done is, first thing to be done बिफोर एयरवे मैनेजमेंट इज टू स्टेबिलाइज द सर्वाइकल स्पाइन, इज टू स्टेबिलाइज द सर्वाइकल स्पाइन. जो हमारा सर्वाइकल वर्टिब्रल रीजन है या सर्वाइकल स्पाइन एरिया है, वहां पे बहुत सारे वाइटल स्ट्रक्चर्स इन्वॉल्व है. सो ड्यूरिंग द मैनेजमेंट और ड्यूरिंग ट्रांसफरिंग ऑफ द पेशेंट देयर शुड नॉट बी एनी चांस इनकी जिसकी वजह से वो इंटैक्ट चीजें भी डैमेज हो जाए. सो फर्स्ट वी विल व्हाट विल डू विल स्टेबलाइज द सर्वाइकल स्पाइन एंड देन वी विल लुक अबाउट द एयरवे मैनेजमेंट. नाउ इन एयरवे मैनेजमेंट इट इज वेरी सिंपल टू थिंग टू डू. फर्स्ट वी विल सी वेदर द पेशेंट कैन स्पीक ऑर नॉट. If he is able to speak, then his airway is intact. This is the simplest and easiest method to check the airway, right? So, airway management, first thing what we'll do, assessment. Assessment kaise karte hain? If the patient is able to speak. If patient is able to speak, patient bol pa raha hai, iska matlab hai ki uska airway hamare paas abhi filhal ke liye to intact. It means airway is intact. Now this is the simplest method to check whether the airway is intact or not. Now there are few things if it is present which means it is a danger sign for the airway and we need to secure or achieve a definite airway, right? So I'll write those four things first. Just put a few star mark and write them. First is the patient is unable to speak. Patient is unable to speak. Second, the patient is comatose. Third, the GCS, that is Glasgow Coma Scale, is less than equal to 8. I will tell you each and everything about Glasgow Coma Scale when we will talk about the disability management. Now, GCS less than 8 and the patient is doing non-purposeful movement. Non-purposeful movement. If any of this four thing is present, if anyone is present, what we will do? We will try to achieve definite airway. So, if anyone is present, we need to achieve definitive airway. And how we do achieve the definitive airway? There is just one thing we should try to think of, that is intubation. So, we intubate the patient in case the patient is not able to speak or the patient's GCS is less than 8 or the patient is comatose or the patient is doing any non-purposeful movement, right? So this is what we do if any danger sign of airway is present, that is intubation. Now if we talk about this intubation, there are two ways. One is orotracheal, okay? And second is nasotracheal. First is orotracheal and second is nasotracheal. Now, nasotracheal is contraindicated in case of an anterior skull-based fracture. But what is most commonly done? We do orotracheal route, right? So, we'll talk about intubation. Intubation we can do in two ways. One is orotracheal intubation. And second, we can do nasotracheal intubation. If someone asks you which is the most common one done, that is orotracheal. Okay? Mostly we intubate through oral cavity, right? We have very rarely seen people getting intubated through nasal cavity. So nasotracheal intubation is less preferred as compared to orotracheal intubation. And even though if you are trying to do it, just remember that it is contraindicated in case of anterior skull base fracture. ठीक है, अगर एंटीरियर स्कल बेस का फ्रैक्चर है तो यू विल नॉट डू एनी नेसोट्रेकल इंटुबेशन, यू विल गो फॉर ओरोट्रेकल. एंड वैसे भी वी प्रेफर ओरोट्रेकल इंटुबेशन मोस्ट कॉमनली. नाउ सपोज दिस ओरोट्रेकल इंटुबेशन फेल और यू डोंट हैव एनी पर्सन हु इज केपेबल ऑफ डूइंग दिस ओरोट्रेकल इंटुबेशन, देन यू हैव टू ऑप्शन. आइडल यू विल डू ट्रेकियोस्टोमी, बट फॉर दैट यू नीड अ फ्यू टाइम. बट द पेशेंट इज ऑलरेडी, पेशेंट का एयरवे कॉम्प्रोमाइज्ड है, दैट टाइम you put a needle in this cricothyroid membrane, right? You need to put the needle in the cricothyroid membrane and try to achieve the airway. Suppose what we are talking now about orotracheal intubation, if it fails or there is no possibility, is not possible, in such case what you will do? The management, we have two things. Emergency mein we'll do needle cricothyroidectomy. right? And definitive management we have, that is tracheostomy. So if it fails or it is not possible, what we'll do? You have two options. One is emergency management and second is definite management. In definite management, what we taught? Definitive management, we do tracheostomy. Definitive management, we do tracheostomy. In case of an emergency that you don't have time to do this tracheostomy, what you will do? You put a needle in this cricothyroid membrane. There is a membrane between this cricoid bone, cricoid cartilage, which is the lowermost part of the larynx, and the thyroid. उसके बीच में एक मेम्ब्रेन है जिसको क्रिकोथायरॉइड मेम्ब्रेन बोलते हैं. उसके अंदर हम एक नीडल इंसर्ट करते हैं सो दैट एयरवे कैन बी अचीव्ड इन इमरजेंसी. सो इफ इट फेल्स एंड नॉट पॉसिबल इमरजेंसी मैनेजमेंट व्हाट वी डू, वी विल डू अ नीडल क्रिकोथायरॉइडेक्टमी. ऑलराइट, नाउ दिस नीडल क्रिकोथायरॉइडेक्टमी इज कॉन्ट्रा इंडिकेटेड वेयर in a child less than 12 years. Okay, also it is contraindicated. Alright, and it is contraindicated in child less than 12 years, and it is contraindicated in severe laryngeal edema, severe larynx edema. ठीक है, now this two condition turns out to be the indication of tracheostomy. भाई जब आप नीडल क्रिकोथायरॉइडेक्टमी कर ही नहीं सकते तो करोगे कैसे? एंड दैट टाइम दिस टू कंडीशन बिकम्स द इंडिकेशन फॉर ट्रेक्योस्टोमी. नाउ दिस आर अबाउट द एयरवे मैनेजमेंट अबाउट द ऑफ द एटीएलएस गाइडलाइन. टू थ्री मोर थिंग आई वांट यू गाइस टू राइट डाउन बिफोर वी मूव ऑन द ब्रीदिंग पार्ट. फर्स्ट दैट द स्पाइन स्टेबिलाइजेशन विच वी डू बिफोर वी गो एंड चेक द एयरवे इज डन using a cervical collar, right? And to examine the back of the patient, we use a technique called as log roll technique, in which minimum 4 people are required. Next line, examine the back of patient. We use log roll technique in which we require minimum four people required. ठीक है, next and last thing in this area only I want you guys to write it, that while transferring patient the patient is put on a hard board. It is done on a hard board. Patient is in supine position, and we put a strap. कहाँ कहाँ पे? On head, on thorax, and on pelvis. Patient is in supine position, and we put strap at head, thorax and pelvis. Right, so this was all about the airway management. Now we'll talk about the breathing, which is a smaller part. We'll talk about breathing. In breathing, what we do? First we do chest examination. And how can we do a chest examination? Obviously by the things which we learn in our med school, that is auscultation, percussion, and palpation, and last one more thing which we do usually first, that is inspection. Right, now these things are done to check conditions like pneumothorax, flail chest, and hemothorax. राइट. सो ब्रीदिंग में दिस इज द थिंग यू शुड रिमेम्बर, वी डू चेस्ट एग्जामिनेशन बाय इंस्पेक्शन, पाल्पेशन, परकशन एंड ऑस्कल्टेशन. विजुअली यूजुअली वी डू दिस ब्रीदिंग एग्जामिनेशन, ब्रीदिंग मैनेजमेंट टू चेक द कंडीशंस लाइक न्यूमोथोरैक्स, हीमोथोरैक्स एंड फ्लाइल चेस्ट. नाउ गोइंग फर्दर विल टॉक अबाउट द सी इन दिस प्राइमरी सर्वे, दैट इज द सर्क्यूलेशन. विल टॉक अबाउट द सी, दैट इज द सर्क्यूलेशन. In circulation, what we come across? We come across problems like increased heart rate and decreased BP. ठीक है, जब भी हम circulation को circulation तक पहुंचते हैं ABCD में, तो जो problem दिखती है, एक तो patient का heart rate बड़ा होता है या तो उसकी BP कम हुई होती है, blood pressure, right? So first thing to be done in case of a circulatory problem is to insert two wide gauge. First thing to be done to two wide bore cannula, preferably 18 gauge, and this 18 gauge is usually or it is green color cannula. ठीक है, जब भी पेशेंट का, जब हम एबीसीडी चेक कर रहे हैं, जब हम सर्कुलेशन पर पहुंचे, तो प्रॉब्लम्स लाइक हार्ट रेट इंक्रीज और बीपी कम, ऐसे प्रॉब्लम दिखेंगे. इसमें सबसे पहले हमें क्या करना है, दो वाइड बोर कैनोलाज लेने हैं और आपको इंसर्ट करना है पेरिफेरली, राइट, एक इस हाथ में एक इस हाथ में. कितना? 18 गेज का. 18 गेज इज यूजुअली ग्रीन कलर, राइट. सपोज यू डोंट हैव एनी ग्रीन कलर कैनोला, यू शुड गो एट 16 गेज. Or the patient is more dehydrated, then also you will prefer 16 gauge or 14 gauge cannula. So, if patient is severely dehydrated, go for 16 gauge or 14 gauge cannula. Okay. Now, what is the fluid of choice? So, IV fluid given is RL, that is Ringer lactate. In case of head injury, we prefer NS, that is normal saline, right? And what is the amount to be given? Amount to be given is 1 liter. Amount is 1 liter, and this is known as judicious fluid therapy. Okay, so सबसे पहले हम क्या कर रहे हैं, 18 gauge का cannula insert कर रहे हैं और peripherally. Suppose ये peripherally हम cannula insert नहीं कर पा रहे, either the limbs are amputated due to trauma or the veins are already collapsed, कि आपके IV cannula से कुछ फर्क ही नहीं पड़ रहा, तो आप क्या करोगे? तब आपके पास तीन ऑप्शंस है. एक तो सेंट्रली आप सेंट्रल लाइन इंसर्ट करोगे थ्रू इंटरनल जुगुलर वेन. सेकेंड, यू कैन गो फॉर वीनस कट डाउन. एंड थर्ड, यू कैन पुट अ इंट्राऑशियस नीडल, राइट, इंट्राऑशियस नीडल यू कैन पुट. सो सपोज व्हाट वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट, इफ दिस पेरिफेरल आईवी कैनोला इंसर्शन इज नॉट पॉसिबल, इफ पेरिफेरल आईवी लाइन इंसर्शन is not possible, then what can you do? You have three options. First, you can put a central line, right? First, you can put a central line, which is the definite management in case of a not able to insert a peripheral cannula. So you'll do a central line, and central line kya karoge aap? This is definite management. And most commonly done at IJV. What is IJV? It is internal jugular vein. Internal jugular vein. ठीक है, circulation का problem का patient है, आप उसको IV cannula insert करना चाहते हो पर IV cannula insert नहीं हो पा रहा, तो सबसे most commonly जो definite management होता है वो जो हम करते हैं उसे हम कहते हैं central line insertion. Central line insertion most commonly it is done in internal jugular vein. Next thing you can do, that is venous cut down. Second, you can do venous cut down, and that is done at ग्रेट सेफेनस वेन, यूजुअली एट ग्रेट सेफेनस वेन, ग्रेट सेफेनस वेन, ठीक है। थर्ड थिंग, यू कैन पुट अ इंट्राऑशियस, मतलब बोन के अंदर यू कैन पुट अ इंट्राऑशियस नीडल, राइट। सो इंट्राऑशियस नीडल इंसर्शन, इंट्राऑशियस नीडल इंसर्शन। नाउ इंट्राऑशियस नीडल इंसर्शन वेयर इट इज डन, इट इज डन एट प्रॉक्सिमल टिबिया और मोर स्पेसिफिकली बिलो द टिबियल ट्यूबरोसिटी। So intraosseous needle insertion is done at proximal tibia more specifically below the tibial tuberosity, below the tibial tuberosity, all right। So this is about the intraosseous needle insertion। Ab intraosseous needle insertion mein jo best initial fluid hoga, that is ringer lactate। Best initial fluid is ringer lactate, but if someone asks you what is the ideal fluid, right, then the answer should be blood। What is the ideal fluid? The answer should be blood, okay। So this was about the condition where you are not able to insert a IV line peripherally। You can do central line insertion, you can do venous cut down, or you can put an intraosseous needle insertion। One more thing you should write in case of a circulation of this ATLS guideline, that is the role of tranexamic acid, role of tranexamic acid, tranexamic acid। Now this tranexamic acid reduces the mortality in adult patient of trauma। Tranexamic acid reduces mortality in adult trauma patient। Now what is the dose? Dose is 1 gram in first 10 minutes and next 1 gram over 8 hours। Okay, so this is the dose or role of tranexamic acid। It will reduce the mortality in case of adult trauma patient। The dose is 1 gram in the first 10 minute and after that in 8 hour you should give 1 gram, right? And what are the indications for this tranexamic acid? So the indications for tranexa, first, the systolic blood pressure is less than 90 mm per hg. Second, the heart rate of the patient is more than 110 beats per minute. Or the patient is having a significant hemorrhage, means it is visible that he is having a lot of blood loss. So these are the three conditions where the role of tranexamic acid comes into play. First, the BP is less than 90 mmHg, the heart rate is very more, that is more than 110 beats per minute, or the patient is having a significant hemorrhage, right? So this was about the circulation part. Circulation mein, for you check, the heart rate is increased either the BP is falling down. In both of the condition, first thing you should do is you will insert two wide bore cannulas peripherally. If you are not able to achieve a peripheral IV line, you go for central line, most commonly in the IGV, that is internal jugular vein. Second, you can do venous cut down, that is at the great saphenous vein. Or third, you can put an intraosseous needle, and the ideal fluid in that condition will become a blood. Tranexamic acid, it will reduce the mortality in case of an adult patient. The dose is 1 gram in the first 10 minute and after that 1 gram over 8 hours. Now we are at the last point of this ATLS guideline, that is the D, that is disability management. Disability management. Now this disability management, mostly it focuses on the GCS, that is the Glasgow Coma Scale. We focus on the GCS, that is Glasgow Coma Scale. Now this Glasgow Coma Scale, you should it is done to assess the neurological status. It is done to assess the न्यूरोलॉजिकल स्टेटस. इन दिस आई वॉन्ट यू टू रिमेंबर फ्यू थिंग. वन इज दैट ईवीएम एंड नंबर 4, 5, 6. नाउ ईवीएम आर द पैरामीटर्स ऑफ द ग्लासगोकोमा स्केल एंड 4, 5, 6 आर द रिस्पेक्टिव हाइएस्ट अमाउंट ऑफ नंबर और स्कोर गिवन इन दैट कंडीशन. सो आई विल मेंशन ईच ऑफ देम वन बाय वन. फर्स्ट इज आई. ईवीएम में द फर्स्ट ई इज आई. सो दिस इज अबाउट आई ओपनिंग. दिस इज अबाउट द आई ओपनिंग. नाउ इन आई ओपनिंग, इफ द ओपनिंग ऑफ आई इज स्पॉन्टेनियस, वी गिव स्कोर 4. इफ द ओपनिंग इज ऑफ आई इज टू द वॉइस, दैट ओपन्स टू वॉइस, then we give a score of 3. If the opening of voice is to pressure or pain, opens to pressure or pain, then the score given is 2. And if the eyes are not responsive, no response, then we give the score of 1. Remember, in all the conditions there is no 0, the minimum score is always 1. Right, so eye opening spontaneous 4, opens to voice 3, opens to pressure or pain 2, and no responses 1. Next we'll talk about the V. The V is about the verbal response. V is about the verbal response. Now what we should know about the verbal response? Again, EVM 4, 5, 6. So the maximum score will be 5. The patient is oriented to time and place. Patient is oriented to time and place. This is considered as 5, V5, right? If the patient is confused, then the score is 4. If the patient is speaking inappropriate word, galia de raha hai, then it is inappropriate words, then it is 3, right? If the patient is giving incomprehensive sound, then the score will be 2. And if no verbal response, the score is, again, minimum score is 1. Okay, so this was about the verbal response. Going further, we'll talk about the motor response. Motor response, maximum score is 6. Right? So in motor response, first, that is, the patient is obeying your command. So he obeys command. The score will be given as 6. If the patient will localizes pain, the score will be 5. If the patient withdrawal to pain, the score given is 4. If the patient is having decorticate rigidity. What is decorticate rigidity? It is abnormal flexion. Then the score given is 3. If the patient is having decerebrate rigidity. Now what is decerebrate rigidity? It is abnormal extension. Then the score given is 2. And no motor response, the score here given will be 1. Right? So this was about the Glasgow-Coma scale. Once again, eye opening, spontaneous, 4, opens to voice 3, opens to pressure or pain 2, and no response 1. Verbal response, oriented to time and place 5, confused 4, incomprehensive word 3, incomprehensive sounds 2, and no response 1. Motor response, maximum 6, so obeys command 6, withdraws pain or localizes pain 5, withdrawals to pain 4, and decorticate rigidity 3, decerebrate rigidity 2, and the no response will be given as 1. Now, one important thing I want you guys to remember, if any of the above out of this EVM, right, is non-testable, for example, intubated patient mein, verbal response cannot be tested, then we write it as VNT, that is verbal response non-testable, right? So minimum score in GCS is 3, maximum score is 15. And how you evaluate this? Suppose the score total comes 13 to 15, then it is mild injury. If the score is 9 to 12, then it is moderate injury. If the score is less than 8, then it is severe injury. Right? So this was about the disability management, and that was all I had to discuss in this video.